was wild, crazy people screaming, all that kind of stuff. And it's hard to believe, but someone, the concerns was, you know, how can we have a heat gun on heat loss in Indiana that we don't know who has for us. Got to make sure it's not. We're not going to have any of that kind of stuff. So that's one of the concerns. And the other thing was, so the other thing I was going to say is that the club meetings have gone to 2 per year. And Cyber Ray should be mentioned. He was in the middle of that. And he was the organizer of any location at this time period. So we had September meetings. And so we were talking about why not have an overnight for the 10th anniversary. And so we did, and Esther, I think, arranged to get the fairgrounds. And we had a couple of years in June, and then it went to July. First year, it was pretty much the same group of people, but there was some, Nick Lukowski came from New York, so there was some, at that time, Bill Spence in the Spears Family Festival in Eastern New York was aware. There was a bit of a Dulcimer boom going on there, and he was referring to people here, a couple of people to come to also, so that's how that came in. But also getting this bubble. And then I was just wondering if anybody can remember, was it Randy here in the 70s? Of course, he was in 75. But we can, and Paul was here in 75, you were here in the 90s. And so, the first year was pretty small. I think I stayed in the tent here, and there was virtually nobody had campers. Went in March, but gradually the priest. Then another thing I wanted to say is that the Fiddlers Association started in '76. And that kind of grew fast, and then 77, there was a 78, one of the Fiddlers Association members was involved with the Camper Club, and so Winnebago's all of a sudden started a period. 78, almost never, not hardly any, prior to that, and then 78, where did it all come from? Then that word passed on from that. People would see each other before to tell them about it. So there was, but one thing that struck me was around 77 or 8, I started seeing people just showing up here that had no particular interest in the Dulcimer, and they just hear about it and show up and you see them standing around. So somehow, at night I remember thinking, yeah, this is pretty amazing. With the light on, and this, I think that year they made a couple of guys in Washington made a record. So those are basically what we remember about the first ever. It was from the 77, 73 to late 70s.
I know that in the early years there was no charge to get in the gate. There wasn't a gate, you don't get involved in. If you drove in, cars were parked everywhere. They passed the hat, passed the bucket in the stage. And people would not put in. Remember that idea? Yes. It was just fun to be here. You must have some questions about the festival, how it's grown, how it's changed.
Now, when did workshops show up?
When did workshops begin? Paul, you have an internet? I have a workshop scheduled from 83
this is early, like 74 maybe, and there wasn't any commercial activity. I think maybe Sony Vegas did it. But Esther had some friends that did some kind of crafts, and they wanted to sell. I don't remember what it was, but she called it the stock was not very well known. Somehow that caused a controversy. So, Gordon is saying that this stuff is only going to be useful for the community. So, that was a minor controversy. But actually, the guy got Gene, and he was the face of the Dulcimer Club, and everybody, not just the meetings, but all the any other events, like the paper or Yankee Springs and the parks and things like that. They did play a bit on TV and a lot with Jay Arnold. I did a lot of things with them too. So he was the public face of the Dulcimer Club. I think he was president from 67 to about 81, I think Gene. And so that was a critical years for the growth, not only because it's ever started, but the club, you know, 67 was pretty small and could have faded, but you know, it kind of kept growing. So and both Gene and Esther worked with the team. They printed out the flyers, and gradually there were this group of side gravity that got these colleges that have sites to hold meetings around the state, being around the state that you have different people and get the crew. And then of course Eric started out just as a large meeting, but in time it became a main activity. Like within, I would say, by 5 or 6 years of planning forever, and the club meetings were just secondary. But they started all by, like, I don't know what years, but I remember the winter meeting started in 75, and so these two meetings here when I started in 71, and that started over. So whenever in 73 was the summer meeting, or 74, that's the cost of these things.
Going back to numbers of China, if I don't know about that, because I think there's a lot of us, and there are no places. But you see this as your daddy. Okay. Memories are cheap because LJ died within 2 years of our problems that I had. 4 years? Okay. So he died early on, and most of the people here don't remember.